So, having discussed all these things, the original topic that we were discussing, starting from chapter 5 about the creation of the universe, initially by Lord Vishnu, then later on by Brahma, about the creation of various living entities, that was going on all the way up to 12th chapter. Then there is a kind of detour about the details. What did Swayambhu Manu do after his creation by Lord Brahma, after obtaining his wife, Satarupa? So now this, now it is further continues. The same discussion now is being continued. So whatever is being discussed on chapter 5 to 12 will also summarized for some time, and whatever details missed in that past discussion will be covered in this chapter. And by the end of this chapter, the creation pastimes will be completed. So in that way, so let's go ahead. This is conversation between Maitreya and Vidura, and then chapter continues about.
Before you go to the next chapter, just I have a small doubt. In the text 32, Maitreya Rishi tells that I have heard it from my spiritual master. Was it Parashara Prabhuji?
Yes, it was Parashara.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
Anyone else want to ask any question related to the Lord Varaha's pastime? Quickly, if you want to ask. Okay, no problem. So here we kind of return to original topic, and in briefly it is summarized, and then the discussion goes ahead. So Shaunaka is speaking now. Shaunaka will ask about their further conversation, the conversation between Maitreya and Vidura. Shaunaka uvacha mahim pratishtam adyasya saute swayambhuvo manu kani anvatishta dvarani marga yavara janmanam. So herein he says that saute posana fromaharshana mahim pratishtam adyasya. So saute swayambhuva manu kani anvatishtad dvarani marga yavara janmanam. So he says that when Lord Brahma told or instructed Swayambhu Manu, please go to Bhumandala and become the king of the Bhumandala and take care of the human beings, then Swayambhu Manu told that, my dear father, I can't see Bhumandala anywhere, seems that it submerged into Garbhodaka Ocean. Please do something to bring it up. Then Lord Brahma meditated upon Lord Vishnu, who appeared from his nostril as a small creature, then eventually grew up bigger, 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 then jumping into Garbhodaka Ocean, searching it and brought it up and kept it where it's supposed to be manifest, etc. So, kani anvatishta dvarani marga yavara janmanam. So, like that, Lord Brahma completed his part of creation with the creation of Swayambhu Manu and Satarupa. Then by the request of Swayambhu Manu and Satarupa, so that the further activities can continue on in this universe, he prayed to Supreme Lord to lift the Bhumandala. That is also done. Now I want to know, what did the sons of Lord Brahma, such as the Prajapatis and Swayambhu Manu, how did they further produce the progeny in this world? Kani anvatishta dvarani marga yavara janmanam. How did they continue the creation further in this world? Can you please continue on what happened afterwards? That is what is requested by Sudha Goswami. Sages of Naimisharanya and Sudha Goswami. Kshetta Mahabhagavata Krishna Krishna Saikanta Krishna Saikanti Kasurhurut Yas Tatya Jagarajam Krishna Yastastya Jagrajam Tusn Krishna Shasapat Sapatyam Agavaniti. It says that Kshatta Mahabhagavata कृष्णा कृष्ण सैकांतिका सुहृत विदुरा वाज ए ग्रेट डिवोटी ही ऑलवेज कंटेंप्लेटेड अपॉन द लोटस फीट ऑफ सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड इन विदिन द कोर ऑफ हिज हार्ट इज ऑलवेज थिंकिंग अबाउट मेडिटेटिंग अबाउट द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड यस तत्याग्रजम कृष्णे सापत्यम अगवान इति and that personality Vidura who left his elder brother and is the sons of his elder brother Duryodhana and the company thinking about Lord Krishna continue to travel all the places sapatyam agavaniti that Dhritarashtra and his sons headed by Duryodhana they were all highly sinful because they did not accept the advice of Lord Krishna thus Vidura left them and began to travel from one pilgrimage to other pilgrimage. Then they continue. Dvaipayanad anvavaro mahitvetasya dehaja sarvatmana shritakrishnam tatparamschapi anurata. So, Dvaipayanad anvavaro अन्ववरो महित्वे तस्य देहजा सर्वात्मना श्रित कृष्ण सो सिंस ही वाज बोर्न ऑफ द्वाई कृष्ण द्वैपायन व्यास विदुरा वाज द सन ऑफ व्यास देव इन दैट सेंस बिकॉज ऑफ हिज इंटरवेंशन ओनली विदुरा टुक बर्थ थ्रू द मेड सर्वेंट ऑफ विचित्र वीर्या सो इन दैट वे दस ही वाज ए ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी लाइक व्यास देव द्वैपायनाद अन्ववरो इज ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर टू व्यासदेव महित्वे तस्य देहिता देहज बिकॉज ही वाज बोर्न फ्रॉम द बॉडी ऑफ द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ व्यासदेव सर्वात्मना श्रित कृष्ण सर्वात्मना आश्रित कृष्ण ही एक्सेप्टेड लॉर्ड कृष्ण हिज लाइफ एंड सोल तत्परांश्चापि अनुव्रता सो ही हैज टेकन द शेल्टर ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्ण विथ हिज माइंड एंड बॉडी कंप्लीटली That is the greatness of Vidura. And then, Kim anva prucham maitreyam virajastirta sevaya virajastirta tevaya upagamya kushavarta asinam tatva vittamam. Having understood that Lord Krishna spoke the final instructions unto Vidura and Maitreya in Prabhas, Vidura, Uddhava and Maitreya in Prabhas. Vidura requested Uddhava, my dear Uddhava, can you please tell me what did the Lord shared with you? Then Uddhava directed him unto Maitreya. And traveling all the way across, Vidura came to Kushavarta. Kushavarta means Haridwar. At Haridwar, he happened to meet Maitreya. And both of them sat on the bank of Ganga. And where they were discussing about Krishna Tattva, Tattva Vittamam. Our Maitreya is Tattva Vittamam, the best of the knowers of the Tattva of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And what kind of further inquiries he made unto Maitreya in order to understand about the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because Virajas Tirtha Sevaya, having traveled from all holy places, having served all the holy places, Vidura become passionless. V Rajas, as a personality who was serving in the royal court, he might had some passion before, but having traveled all the holy places, he completely purified himself of the passionate mentality. Now he is completely pure. So he must have asked only about the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we would like to know, what did he ask and what did he heard from Maitreya? All those details we want to know. Tayo samvadato suta pravruttahi amalakata apoganga ivagagner hare pada ambujashraya. This is again. तयो दोस्तु संवदता सूता माय डियर सूत गोस्वामी संवदता प्रवृत्ता ही अमलाकता those two are wonderful devotees, they must have discussed amala katha, spotless krishna katha, spotless hari katha, they must have continued further. Apo ganga ivag agnir, and more than that, they sat on the bank of ganga, which is the purifier of all the sinful tendencies. They themselves are pure, and they also sat on the bank of ganga, which is all the purifier. Triloka pavani hare padambujashraya having te, which appeared from the lotus feet of Lord Hari, Lord Vamana. Ganga, which emanated from the lotus feet of Lord Vamana, which took shelter of Lord Vamana's lotus feet, and they have taken shelter of Ganga, which has taken shelter of Lord's lotus feet. In a way, they have taken shelter of Lord's lotus feet. They must have discussed Lord Hari's amalakata. So can you kindly elaborate on that? Can you kindly repeat it? We want to know, we want to hear that. So this is the desire of the great devotees, the sages of Naimisharanya. Tana kirtaya badram te kirtanyodara karmana rasajna kono trupyeta hari lila amrutam piban. Tana kirtaya badram te, badram te, let there be auspiciousness unto you. Actually, in one sense, the Shaunakadi rishis are elder in age with respect to Sudha Goswami. Sudha Goswami is actually a younger personality. And the sages of Naimisharanya, headed by Shaunakadi rishis, they were all elder in age. And so they are all blessing, pronouncing blessings unto Sudha Goswami. Let there be auspiciousness unto you. Tana kirtaya badrante, please continue to describe Krishna katha. Kirtanya udara karmanam, kirtanya udara karmanam, can you kindly describe the glories of udara karmanam, that supreme lord who performs magnanimous pastimes? Continue to describe them. Why? Because rasajna kon trupyeta, those people who really got the taste of experiencing Krishna katha, how can they be satisfied by hearing one Krishna katha alone? They would like to hear continuously more and more. Prasajna konu trupyeta, who can be satisfied by hearing Krishna katha only a small quantity? They want to hear more and more. Harilila amrutam priman, they want to drink harilil, the nectar of harilila, more and more, more and more, more and more. So kindly continue on, don't stop in between here and there. Please go on, continue on describing Krishna katha. So this is the eagerness of the sages of Naimisharanya. The speaker is eager to speak Krishna katha, the hearers are eager to hear Krishna katha. Then there will be the manifestation of wonderful pastimes of Supreme Lord. So that is how it is being described. So there in the same Bhagavatam Canto 3, later on very soon we are going to discuss this chapter. There is one verse in the 25th chapter wherein it is said that tatam prasangan mama virya samvido bhavanti hrutkarna rasayana kada tadjoshanadasu apavarga vartmani shraddha ratir bhaktir anukramishyati. So here one important point we should be noting, that it is not that anywhere and everywhere this kind of effect can be possible. For this effect to be possible, there should be a proper combination of the hearer and the speaker. It says that satam prasangan mama virya samvido, satam prasangan, satam sangha, the association of devotees. The satam prasanga means the association of best two devotees. Lord Kapila says, in the association of best devotees, mama virya samvido, my pastimes will be revealed. In the association of normal devotees, my pastimes are discussed or heard. But in the association of my best devotees, my pastimes are revealed. They will be manifested in their presence. So that is what is being mentioned in this verse. There is one narration which comes in Bhagavata Mahatmya. So wherein the entire event goes like this. A little bit story. This we have already discussed at the beginning of the third canto. But still, according to the time situation, now we'll just repeat it. We will discuss. So Lord Krishna stayed in Vrindavan of course, Gokul Mahavan, then Vrindavan, then Nandagaon, all these places for 11 and a half years. Approximately during the 12th year, little later, 11 and a half years, Akrura came to Nandagaon. According to Akrura, Lord Krishna is the son of Vasudev. According to Rajavasis, Lord Krishna is the son of Nanda Maharaj. Both are true. No one is wrong. So Akrura came and told, my dears, of course, in one sense, because they are family relationship, they might say that, my dear son, your parents are being tortured and tormented by Kamsa for so many years, for last 15, 20 years, since the time they married. They are behind bars. They were being tortured by Kamsa. Can't you come and deliver them? Then both Krishna and Balaram became concerned about the deliverance of his parents, Devaki and Vasudev. Then Lord Krishna prepared to go to Madura. That time all the Vrajavasis, starting with the eldest of the eldest and the youngest of the youngest, all of them approached Krishna, requesting him to stay back in Raja, not to go to Vrindavan, not to go to Madura, not to go to Madura. Then Lord Krishna promised all of them, especially the gopis. He said that, I'll go there, I'll kill Kamsa, I'll deliver Devaki Vasudev, and I'll come the day after tomorrow. I'll go today, I'll do the tomorrow everything, I'll settle everything tomorrow night, and day after tomorrow I'll come back. Just give me 2 days. I will be back in Raja. I'll not stay there completely. With this promise, Lord Krishna went to Madura. He killed Kamsa. Balaramji killed all the other associates of Kamsa, his brothers and army, etc., etc. And Kamsa's two wives immediately went to Magad, informing their father, Jarasandha, that Krishna came achanak, unexpectedly, and he killed our husband, our pious religious husband. Please do something. You go and kill him and bring satisfaction to my husband, our husband. Like that, he has two wives, the two daughters of the Jarasandha went and complained. Lord Krishna understood all these things. If I go to Raja, Kamsa might wage war at both the places, in Madura as well in Raja. Because I am not there in Madura, the Madura people will get affected by Jarasandha. If I go to Raja, Raja is not a place of royalty. It is a common place of the paddy fields and simple lively lifestyle is there. And the entire simple and happy lifestyle of the Vrajavasis will get disturbed. Thinking thus, Lord Krishna stayed back in Madura only for a few more days. He requested and pacified Nanda Maharaj and all the cowherd men that, so my dear father, you please go back and myself and my brother will come to Raja after a few days. Let us stay with Devaki and Vasudev for a few more days. He did not inform that Jarasandha is making plans to wage war against Madura. He did not inform that. Otherwise, Nanda Maharaj will become disturbed. He just simply said that, I will stay with Devaki Vasudev for a few days and we kind of give them some satisfaction that we are with them and we'll come back. So, Nanda Maharaj went back to Raja, informed everything to Yashodamai and all the other ladies. They were crying. They were waiting for Krishna that Krishna will come soon. And in the meantime, Jarasandha waged war. Lord Krishna and Balaram killed all the army brought by Jarasandha. Jarasandha first time brought. That time, the kings of entire area, entire Bharatavarsha were under the control of Jarasandha. He was like the monarch. Every king lent their army. So the total army of 23 Akshahuni was there. The 23 Akshahuni were destroyed by Krishna and Balaram quickly. Only the leaders are spared. So Krishna and Balaramji thought that we have appeared on this in this world for Paritranaya Sadhuna Vinashayat Duskutam. All the impious people to kill them. And Bhubara Harayana to reduce the burden of the earth, we came here. And Jarasandha is doing our work. He can bring all the impious people at one go. And we can stay here and kill them. We don't have to go here and there, here, there, here, there, here, there. So let us spare Jarasandha instead of killing him. So Jarasandha will again bring other people and make a battle once again here in Madura. So till then, we should not go to Braj. We'll stay in Madura only. That was the decision. So by the way, few months passed, few a couple of years also passed. In the meantime, on the Himalayas, Pandu Maharaj died. His wife Kunti and the five children were brought back to Hastinapur by the great sages, and they delivered Pandavas, the five Pandavas, under the care of Bhishma. Understanding that Pandu, who was a pious king, had given birth to, in the sense, by the prayers of the, by the blessings of the devatas through their prayers, five wonderful sons, five religious and powerful sons. So many of the kings all over Bharatavarsha kind of said no to support Jarasandha. They have given up their support towards Jarasandha. But whoever the envious kings, till now the others also, out of fear, they were supporting Jarasandha. But now on, some of them withdraw their support to Jarasandha. And Jarasandha could not get so much army. So now only with the limited supporters, he collected only limited army. And he began to wage war after war, war after war. Every year, he kind of waging war on Madura. So year after year, he was kind of attacking Madura. So the Krishna and Balram were busy doing this task. They could not go to Vraja. So Lord Krishna sent Uddhava in order to pacify Vrajavasis, especially the gopis, with a letter. So Uddhava went there. He tried to pacify Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda and the gopis. Instead of pacifying them, he pacified himself. I was thinking these people are ordinary village people, but these are not ordinary. These are extraordinary devotees. Whatever devotional sentiments they have for Lord Krishna, I don't have even an iota. He stayed there and he could hear about the Supreme Lord for 2 months. For 2 months, all the gopis took Uddhava to different places where all Lord Krishna performed different pastimes. He heard all the pastimes of Vraja gopis. Lord Krishna with Vraja gopis, with elderly gopis, with elderly gopas, all the variety of pastimes. Everything Uddhava heard. Uddhava completely transformed. He came back. He was completely Krishnaized. So then eventually, thinking that enough is enough, let us stay away from fighting with Jarasandha, Lord Krishna moved all the Madura vasis to Dwaraka. Then eventually married Rukmini, Jambavati, Satyabhama, like that eight principal kings after killing Narakasura or Baumasura. 16,100 queens like that, he married many. So Bhagavatam explained that the eight principal queens are direct expansions of eight Radharani and the Ashtasakhi gopis. So they were completely satisfied with their way of serving Lord Krishna. But the other daughters of all so many kings, the 16,100 queens of Lord Krishna, they heard that Lord Krishna used to perform many pastimes with Vraja gopis in Vraja. So they understood that, they heard that Uddhava also visited Vraja once, and he heard from Vraja gopis about all the pastimes of Lord Krishna. They would always call Uddhava and request him to narrate Lord Krishna's pastimes in association with Vraja gopis. So all these people would always hear about Lord Krishna. Throughout their life, as they were living in Dwaraka, they would always continuously hear from Uddhava the pastimes of Lord Krishna, which he performed with the gopis. Eventually, 125 years completed, Lord Krishna departed from this world, having taken all the Dwaraka vasis to Prabhas, making them fight with each other and delivered them completely. Then Balramji disappeared and Lord Krishna disappeared. Everything is over. The eight principal queens entered into Sati, along with Lord Krishna, the wives of Balramji entered into Sati. They all disappeared. That the 16,100 queens of Lord Krishna are still there. Arjuna wanted to take them back to Hastinapur so that they can stay under the care of Yudhishthir Maharaj. But on the way, because these queens previously, they were the heavenly damsels. So once Ashtavakra Muni visited to debate with a king. So as Ashtavakra Muni came to debate with the king, these ladies served him very nicely. and he became very much happy. He pronounced a blessing upon them that may you become the consorts of the Supreme Lord. So they were happy, but unfortunately they did not understood that Ashtavakra Muni has some irregularities in his body. Later on, at some other occasion, Ashtavakra Muni was walking ahead in a particular way, because Ashtavakra Muni has bends at 8 places in his body. That's why he is called Ashtavakra Muni. Previously he was seated nicely and they served him very nicely. They never saw him before like walking as he stood. So now first time they saw him, he stood in a eightfold bending form and he was walking in a peculiar way. They did not know that he was Ashtavakra Muni. They were looking from behind, so they kind of laughed at him. And he turned around, and while turning around only, kind of cursed, "You people are laughing at me because of my physical deformities. May you be stolen by thieves." So then, as he turned around, they understood that it is Ashtavakra Muni. They immediately came and fell down at his lotus feet. And Ashtavakra Muni understood that I already blessed them that they will become. But anyway, so he blessed and also kind of cursed. So in order to fulfill both the words of Ashtavakra Muni, Lord Krishna accepted them as his wives, and Lord Krishna, now taking the form of thieves, came and fought with Arjuna, defeated Arjuna, took all of them and brought them back to Indraprastha. So actually Lord Krishna's grandson, Lord Krishna's son was Pradyumna, Pradyumna's son was Aniruddha, Aniruddha's son was Vajranab. Arjuna made Vajranab as the king of Indraprastha. So because there is nothing left in Madura or Dwaraka, so Indraprastha was there, he made him king of Indraprastha. So Krishna took all these queens back to Indraprastha and put them under the care of Vajranab, and it disappeared. So then when Arjuna went to Hastinapur, he revealed everything, he narrated everything, that Krishna's disappearance and the final rites of Krishna and all the Aidus. Yudhishthira Maharaj retired and went to Himalayas. All the 5 Pandavas, Draupadi, they followed. They made Parikshit Maharaj the next king. Then Parikshit Maharaj wanted to visit Vajranab and Madura and other places, Vrindavan also. So he immediately went to Indraprastha. There he met Vajranab. He also met all the queens of Lord Krishna who were actually experiencing pain of separation from Lord Krishna, who were highly painful situation. And then both Vajranab and Parikshit Maharaj approached all those queens. "Please tell us what we can do in order to pacify all of you, how you can be relieved of all your pain of separation from Lord Krishna." Then the queens who would always continuously hear from Uddhava about the pastimes of Lord Krishna that he performed along with Vrajavasis and especially Gopis, they said that, "So the only way we can be relieved of our pain is that we would like to go to Vraja and visit all those places where all Lord Krishna performed pastimes." Uddhava told us many times that Lord Krishna performed so and so pastime here, so and so pastime there, so and so pastime there. We would like to visit Vraja. So both Parikshit Maharaj and Vajranab escorted all the queens of Lord Krishna towards Vraja. First they went to Madura, then from Madura to Vrindavan, they need to cross Yamuna. As they approached Yamuna, Yamuna was flowing jubilantly, and the queens became a little bit angry at Yamuna. "Oh, my dear Kalindi, how can you be so happy and flowing very jubilantly? Is not fair. Just now our husband departed and you should be crying. You should be in lamentation. How can you be so jubilant?" Then Kalindi replied that, "My dear Sakis, my dear friends, so there is no way that we can forget our dear Lord. As long as we think about him, he's always with us. No way we can be separated from our dear Lord. I knew that all of you were always hearing our Lord's pastimes from Uddhava. And currently Uddhava is there on the bank of Kusum Sarovar as Gulmalata. Please go there and request Uddhava to repeat the pastimes of Lord Krishna, our pastimes of our Lord, so that your pain of separation, pain of anguish will be relieved." So following the word of Kalindi, they all went to the bank of Kusum Sarovar. There they were shouting loudly to Uddhava, my dear Uddhava, please come, please come. So on the other side of Govardhan, there is a place known as Uddhava Baitak, even today also. That is the place. No, no. On the bank of Kusum Sarovar, Uddhava was actually in the invisible form. That is, they became like Gulmalata. Hearing the cries of the gopis, aided by Parikshit Maharaj and Vajranab, Uddhava came out and came in front of them. And they all became very happy. And they requested Uddhava that, please, we are all experiencing the pain of separation from Lord Krishna. Please do something to relieve our pain of separation of our Lord. Then Uddhava took all of them across Govardhan onto the place known as Uddhava Baitak today. That is where he made all of them seated and Uddhava narrated the pastimes of Lord Krishna with Vrajavasis. As he was narrating all the pastimes, and they were all experiencing the presence of Lord Krishna. Like that, the narration went on for one complete month. And at the culmination of the narrations, at the end of the month, then all queens of Lord Krishna, 16,100 queens, and Vajranab, they could see the pastimes of Lord Krishna, which they heard from the mouth of Uddhava, are manifesting in front of them, in presence of them. So they manifested, and immediately Lord Krishna withdrew all the 16,100 queens into his aprakatalila. And along with them, also Lord Krishna performed same pastimes once again in the vision of Uddhava and Vajranab. Later on, in order to remember all those pastimes, Uddhava installed all the wonderful deities, all those pastime places like Radha Govindji, Radha Madhamohanji, all these were installed by Vajranab 5,000 years back at that time. But here the interesting thing is that if the discussion is happening between the personality like Uddhava, a great devotee like Uddhava, and it is heard by great devotees like the 16,100 queens of Lord Krishna, at the culmination of the narration, the pastimes are manifested in presence in front of them. So this is the effect. That is what is being said by Lord Kapila here in this verse. Satam prasangam mamavirya samvido. If the pastimes of mine are heard in the presence of wonderful combination of devotees, they will be manifested in person. Then, if one actually, whatever one hears, if one witnesses in front of them, they will develop nishta, then ruchi, then asakti to hear more and more. Then they will start manifesting the symptoms of bhava, because they are actually witnessing and experiencing the pastimes of Supreme Lord. They will manifest the symptoms of bhava, and then eventually prema will appear for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Satam prasanga mamavira samito bravanti rutkarna rasayana kada tadjoshana dashu apavarga vartmani shraddha ratir bhakti ranukramishyati. All these things will manifest one after the other. They will come to the platform of prema. So this is the glory of hearing Krishna Katha in the association of wonderful devotees. So that is being glorified in the previous chapter and here in this chapter also. Prasajna kona seveta hari lilamutam priman. So which person who relishes Krishna Katha will be satisfied by hearing little Krishna Katha? They want to hear more and more. Here it is said, they want to drink the nectar of Krishna Katha more and more. They will not be satisfied by little Krishna Katha. Evam ugrashrava prashta rishibir naimishayanai bhagavati arpitadhyatmas tan aha shruyatamiti. Being thus requested by the sages of Naimisharanya about the topics of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sudha Goswami, the son of Ugrashrava, began to narrate the pastimes of Supreme Personality of Godhead. So then he said that, Tan aha shruyatamiti, I will narrate what happened afterwards. Kindly listen. Shruyatamiti, kindly listen. So then Suta Goswami began to speak. Suta uvacha harer dutak krodatana samayaya nishamya gorvud उद्धरणं रसातलात् लीलामिरण्याक्षं अवज्ञयाहतं संजातः शो मुनिमहाभारत. So he said that hearing how Lord Varaha appeared and lifted the Bhumandala and killed Hiranyaksha, Vidura became very much happy. And then he inquired from Maitreya further. Vidura uvacha prajapati pati srishtva prajasarge prajapatin किम आरभता किम आरभत मे ब्रह्मन् प्रभुरि अव्यक्त मार्गवेद. Wherein Vidura is asking that, O Brahmana, the knower of the Tattva of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, kindly please tell me, what did Brahma do after creating all the Prajapatis all the way up to Swayambhuva Manu? Having created the four Kumaras, Lord Shiva, the 11 Rudras, and then 10 Manasa Putras headed by Narada Muni and Daksha and Vashishtra, Vara, etc., etc., Kardama Muni and many others, eventually, finally, Swayambhuva Manu and Satrupa. Then what did you do? Kim Arabata Me Brahman Prabhur Avyakta Margavit. What else he did further? So here is Prabhu Avyakta Margavit. So my dear Prabhu, my dear Maitreya Rishi, you who know Avyakta Marga, you are the knower of the path back home back to Godhead, the knower of the true of the Supreme Lord, Avyakta Margavit. So in that way. E Marichi Adayo Vipra Yastu Swayambhu Manu Tevai Brahmana Deshat Katam Etat Abhavayan. So here said that, what did Brahmana said by Marichi and others do having they were created by Brahma? Marichi Adayo Vipra Yastu Swayambhu Manu Tevai Brahmana Adeshad Katam Etad Avavayat. As by the order of Lord Brahma, how did they create further? Please narrate the creation of all these great personalities, Swayambhu Manu and the great Prajapatis. Till now you have talked about the creations of Brahma. Now you please talk about the creation of all these great personalities. Sadvitiya ki masrujan Swatantra Utakarmashu Ahasvi Samhata Sarva Idam Sma Samakalpayan. Along with their wives, Sadvitiya, they with their wives, how did they do further creation? Especially Swayambhuva Manu obtained his wife Satrupa. How did Swayambhuva Manu begot children and then they further begot children? Please talk about all these things. How did other Prajapatis also married and they begot children? Talk about these things in detail. Then Maitreya repeats. So from verse number 12 to 17, kind of Maitreya summarizes what he spoke in the first few chapters, chapter 5 to 10. And then 18 to rest of the chapter talks about as part of Brahma's creation, whatever is not being spoken elaborately, that will be discussed here. And the subsequent creation of Prajapatis and Swayambhu Manu, etc., will be discussed from 21st chapter onwards. So it is like that. Next few verses, a summary of Vishnu's creation. And the rest of the chapter is all about Lord Brahma's creation. But whatever is left over, whatever is not discussed previously, is discussed here now. And from next chapter onwards, the creation of Prajapatis and Swayambhuva Manu, etc. further. So that is how the connection with respect to the questions of Vidura and the rest of the chapter. So today we'll stop here, and tomorrow we'll do the discussion of how the Maitreya is narrating back to Vidura. So we are stopping at 11th verse, and it is 8:48 or something like that. If any questions, couple of questions we'll take, then we'll have Kirtan by His Grace Vishwabhanu Prabhu and etc. Any queries?
Haribol.
Yes, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna
Guruji.
Hare Krishna, yes. There are no questions.
From all other devotees, if there are no questions, then we can request Prabhuji to do Kirtan.
Rishabhanu Prabhu, are you okay with the Kirtan today? Can you do?
Yeah, I'll do. Yes.
Okay.
Just in a minute, I'll get Kirtan and do it. Not in a minute.
All right.
No problem. In the meantime, if your devotees have any question, quick question, or anything you want to share about this topic. Okay.
So everybody is fully contented with your class. Totally.
I don't know. Whatever way. Of course, we did not discuss much here today. All like kind of simple slokas. Nothing doubt.
Oh, Prabhuji, the complete katha you told, that was really amazing.
Fascinating, Prabhuji. Really fascinating.
Yeah,
Hare
really. Katha was really fascinating.
Yeah.
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deva.